Hello everybody, my name is Akminox. Welcome to another Idorios video. Today we will be checking out Guild Settlement. I will try to explain what happens here. So, yesterday it was a chaos. No one knew what they were doing. This is a little messed up because of that, but yeah, we will see. So, first things first, let's check the quest. You put a hero. I just selected the only one where I don't have any hero. So yeah, you put a hero here, and then you get points based on how much enables the hero has, or stars. At E5, you will get 4080 points for yourself, and then you will give your guild 136 points. So if you have 30 members all online, you can get 8000 points in a day if you coordinate everyone. So that takes us to from indifferent to neutral because it's only 5000 points. So what happens when you upgrade it? You just get two more guild coins per hour, that's all. This is only the first level, indifferent, and then you get to neutral, which boosts up from 5 to 7 guild coins, and you can see the change in total output. This is the amount you get per hour, which accumulates up to 10,000, so you have to collect it by clicking here every once in a while. Don't get it to max amount. So yeah, this is the basics of it. You wanna try to work with your guild. That's the main thing here. So yesterday I put my hero in neutral. I put Rogan, I guess. I got 4000 points, and like 15 people put it with me, which made us, or maybe even more because it can get to a limit at 5000. So the other people helping me made this go to 5000. When it gets to 5000, we can see here. And then yeah, I wrote to my guild about the Dark Abyss. Like, we did Sara Forest, now we are gonna do Dark Abyss. And if someone did Dark Abyss yesterday, they can do Sara Forest today. This way both of them will be level 2 and we can get the income from them. So yeah, now we will be putting hero in the Dark Abyss. I will put whatever. We get the rewards. And see, we got 4000 points and got to 5000 total. So now we have to do an ascension quest. It's weak anyway. Whatever you put, you will win it. Which upgraded the indifferent to neutral and increased our guild coin amounts. You can see it here. It was 62 per hour, now it's 64. So now it reset after killing the boss to 5000. You didn't get the extras from earlier. Like, this was at almost 2000. So yeah, we are missing the other 1000. But it's okay. You wanna do the bosses early, if you can. That way you will have extra points like this one. So yeah, you wanna work with your guild. And then you wanna make a path for your guild as well, where everyone has mostly E5s on these classes or factions. So, as you can see, some of our guild members put their points in Transcendence, which, like, more than half of us don't have Transcendence right now. So, I don't know if they even donated it two times here, because they are lowering their own guild coin income. If they just put them here and here, they would have 4 extra income here. If they did two times here, they will have 62 right now. So yeah, leaving the Transcendence as last is probably the best way. And if you don't have enough members to get Transcendence to 5000 in one day, you might just wanna skip it. Start working on level 3 for whatever you wanna do. Which is, depends on the guild, depends on the Age of Server, Innivir Guilds, this is gonna be very hard to do. Like, people build different heroes in the beginning. Like Itakura, Penny, Inosuke, I don't know. There are a few. And they all have different classes and factions, so yeah, it's gonna be hard to organize at the beginning. But as I said, you get half of the points, like 4,000, for yourself. And you get 4,000 from the guild. So yeah, at the worst case scenario, you will do double the job yourself. That's as bad as it gets. Other than that, yeah, after you get this to indifferent from no, natural, from indifferent to natural, you will need to do 15,000 points for next level. Meaning everyone has to work on the same settlement 2 days, if everyone has an E5, that is. Because you need to have two E5s, for example, in forest, to do this in 2 days. If everyone has that, go ahead for it. If most people has that, go ahead for it. You need to check your guild members, their heroes, their bags. Yeah, it's a little hard. Other than that, yeah, you can make a path for your guild. Or your leader will probably message you if they are working for it. You need to make a path. We did it like since our server is quite old. We have no problem with light and dark. And you know, everyone has a Tixo, Shadow. I don't know, like, classes are very easy to do in older accounts. And then you can leave like Fortress, Abyss, Forest. And then lastly, Transcendence. So yeah. Most of the problem is if people put 2 days in a row in the same settlement. Because, like, say this now. One person put an E5 in this fortress faction, and he is at 4,000 points right now, himself, not the guild. So if he goes ahead and puts another E5 today or tomorrow or whenever, before guild helps him, he will waste 3,000 points. He will only get to 5,000 after 2 times 4,000 donation. And that means a day is wasted because the guild was gonna complete it anyway for him. So yeah, don't split up from your guild. It's only hurting yourself. Don't put in the same settlement in these first 12 days at least. Because you wanna do them one by one every day, and at the end of 12th day you wanna have complete all of them to level 2. And yeah, the boss is easy to do, so no problem for that. For now, I think. And for the second, after natural, yeah, you need to do it 2 times. Make sure to get one of them to level 3 and then switch to another one. Like, some people might be missing E5 star, they will put 10 stars in. They might be behind in points, so I don't know, it's gonna get a little bit hard to manage. But yeah, everyone should work together, get them to next level one by one. And if someone is lacking behind, I don't know what to do yet. We will see, I guess. Yeah, I just switched to another account. As you can see here, I donated to Fortress. The reason for that is, I am gonna regress this Sigmund and Inosuke today. So, you know, I wanted to put those 4,000 points into use. And also give my guild members the maximum points, 136. So yeah, after today, I won't be having a Fortress hero. That's why I did this today. It's gonna suck for me because I'm gonna miss income every day now due to doing this. But it's okay, like, not that much of a deal for 2 grid coins per hour. Yeah, This is the situation. Yesterday I put in light because, as I said, it's very easy to do light and dark in these old accounts. But yeah, our guild decided to do forest. I don't know, I guess everyone wants to use their Garudas or Rogans. Yeah, our Transcendence only has two. I don't know what happened. If the same guy did it twice, it's very bad for them. I mean, I guess it doesn't change much because he's only behind a day. Unless he keeps going for it. Sometimes you can't manage everyone. So yeah, that covers it, I guess. Overall, follow what your leader says. It's better for you and the whole guild. Like, you don't lose anything if you follow him. Even if you don't have an E5 there, like putting a 10 star in, it's fine because if you select another settlement and put an E5 there, if people don't do it with you, you aren't getting to level 2 anyway, so you are not missing. Follow your leader. If you're a leader, make a path for your guild. You can send. I am sending an email every day. Today we are doing this one, tomorrow we are doing this one. Like, sending one mail per day is okay, I think. This is gonna get lost anyway in a while. It's gonna get very chaotic. So, yeah. If your guild doesn't communicate, find a guild, another guild maybe, they will communicate. Otherwise, if you wanna still stay in that guild, you can just wait for the end of day, you know, wait for people to put 1000 points in it. So, for example, this is already more than 1000. You can go for this, make it 5000 and get your bonus reward. Extra guild coins per hour. Yeah, that's all I can say about it for now. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys tomorrow in next video. Bye bye.